Hello everybody and welcome to my channel. Today is midweek mini number 4, small talk and small orders. Hope you're all well. It is bank holiday weekend in the UK. I'm filming on the 27th, on Saturday the 27th. The sun is shining, the birds are singing on the TV and outside. You might hear some traffic, I'm afraid. But yeah, it is the first time I'm recording for probably a month. I seem to have the energy and I just filmed about 8 boxes in a row. So all of the ones that you're seeing for the next couple of weeks and the ones you've seen the last week are ones that I filmed back in just out of about a week or two after my accident. And so yeah, I'm trying to get back in the swing of things and we are filming, so the room might look different. If you notice, I'm just starting to set up my Luther altar, and you're probably going to see the next video and it's going to have Beltane. So yeah, and you may notice, anybody eagle-eyed, that I used to have my tarantulas here. Me being me, when I was resting and I felt like I wanted to do something, I thought I'd tidy up in here and I ended up moving things around. So I've now got my bureau altar here next to my filming altar and the one that I use for doing anything like painting and stuff, so it's easy to wipe down. And then that's my kind of private altar there, which you've seen a glimpse of. I think it was over Vlogmas. So I might do a little room tour another week if you want to see it. It's up to you. But yeah, I've moved a few things around. Redone the wall over here, the postcard art print wall. And yeah, I'm quite liking how it's looking now. But anyway, let's get on with the first of the small orders. And bearing in mind, some of these have been here weeks and weeks and weeks. So we're probably going to try and get a few today. So first up, now this has been here. And I just pulled the label off so I could film. But I think this has been here about 6 weeks, this one. And as you can see, I've not even opened it. But it's been here that long, I couldn't actually remember what it was until I saw what the seller had written there or what company it came from. But let's open it and we'll have a talk. I'm going to open it from the bottom because I did have a quick sneak peek just as I was about to film, because I wanted to see if they put a business card in because I couldn't remember who it was from. So this is... Oh, yeah, this is... a moss agate tower. Anyone who's been here a little while will know that my favourite stone is moss agate. I got this from a seller from the Enchanted Emporium Fayres UK, and I will link it all below. This is really well wrapped. But yeah, you can never have too much moss, and here it is. It's stunning. It will go and keep my plants protected. Really nice size tower, love it. And that came from, here you go, the crystal sphere. So there's all the details, but they'll also be below. So sticking with crystals, we'll get one more done and then we'll move on to some chat. Now I can't get the label off this, but this is, I've just opened it now, from my wonderful usual crystal supplier, Aura Blends, who will be linked below. She is amazing, Gemma. And yeah, she really is amazing. And it's just a mini order, and I can't remember what's in it because I love her stickers, holographic stickers. Because it's been a while. But yeah, I think there's a sphere necklace. I'll have a look. Yes, there is. So here it is, it's tourmaline. I love any fidget sort of necklaces for when I'm anxious. And she wraps these herself, really beautiful. I usually change the cord and put a different one on, so it's a bit longer and I can adjust it however long I want then. So that's that, just a simple fidget sphere, I love that. So that's number one. I think, if I remember rightly, she sometimes does on Facebook, rather than lives, she does a post where she puts in listings and you can make her offer and she'll accept or decline the offer. I think that's where that one came from. I might be wrong though, because it's been a while. And then we have this one. I'm pretty much as surprised as all of you because I can't remember what I ordered at the best of times, especially when it's been a while. So let me just open this one. She always wraps everything really well. Hang on, I can get in there, I think. So, yes. Oh, it's a sphere. Oh, surprise, surprise. Is it lost? Oh, no, it's not lost. It's lab. So this one was 15. Randomly, I have lab in quite a few different free forms and loads of different types. Oh, the sticker's very sticky on there. I'll get it off properly afterwards. But I don't have a lab sphere. I was quite shocked that I didn't have a lab sphere. I have like lab towers, I have lab tumbles, palm stones, lots of different ones, but I don't have a lab sphere. Is this gonna show up well on here? Let me see if I can move the light a bit closer. Can you see the, yeah. There you go, you can see the blue shimmer and shine on it. Can you see that there? Lab is always, so Labradorite or Labradorite. I always call it Labradorite. Labradorite is what it should be, I think. Or Lab, it gets called for short. So a nice sphere there, and I've got lots of spare stands at the minute because I got a load. If you saw my last Aura Blends video, I got a load of stands for sphere stands because I collect quite a lot of spheres. So that is a lab sphere. Is that the last one? Yeah. So it was just those two in that order. I told you it was a small one. Very unusual for me. So yeah. So there we go. A nice small order from Aura Blends. All the details for Aura Blends will be below. Next up. If you saw my last, well, my first Coven UK mystery box, the Wicked Witch one, which will be linked below, I had a damaged necklace. I wasn't worried about it because I knew they'd be easy to deal with and get that sorted. And I messaged Kelly about it and I said, but don't worry, pop it in with my next mystery box. I'm in no rush for it. And bless her heart, she messaged back and said, well, I've already put it in the post, which is amazing. Well, here it is. I did sneak peek because I wasn't sure what it was at the time because it came so quickly. So, here, one of their famous stripy black and white bags. But bless her heart, she put extras in. I mean, that is so kind. I'd never expected that. So here is the replacement necklace, the beautiful Zelda necklace. So there's that. Really pretty necklace. This was a was there a stone out or... Oh no, that was it. The original one, the middle wasn't in properly, it was out. So yeah, that's the replacement one, which was very nice of them. And then they sent me extras. They sent me a Spooky for Life badge, which is so sweet, so kind of them. And then this is a sticker, it's like a mirror sticker. That is so cool, right? Oh, there you go, you can see my moon gazing hair there. But yeah. And they sent me a bigger one, so I've got two of these, which is so kind. They didn't have to do that. Who are we going to look at now? There's the hair. Where's the... Oh, let me go that way. There's the Wicked Witch artwork that I got in that box. So yeah, that was really kind of them to do that. So thank you very much to Coven UK Kelly there, who sorted that out for me. So yeah, that is the first three of the minis. Technically that wasn't an order, that was a replacement, but I just thought it was so kind to send the extras, so thank you very much. I didn't expect them to send it so quickly, or the extras or nothing. That was really kind. So yeah, how are you guys? Are you enjoying the weather? It's getting quite muggy here. We had an infestation of wild bees, not honeybees, wild bees, a couple of days ago. We thought we might have a nest, but I think it was just a swarm must have gone across. And some got lost or something. We evacuated about 15 of them from the house, had to catch them and get them out. Unfortunately, there were a couple of casualties, which was nothing to do with us. We just found them on windowsills and stuff afterwards. But they're going to be preserved because I do stuff like that. And I thought we got rid of them. And then yesterday, I went to pick up a glass from the draining board. And one must have been behind it. And I got nicely stung. So, well, not yesterday, day before, sorry. So, yeah, my finger swelled up really big. Thankfully, I knew I wasn't allergic because I was stung once before when I was a kid. But, yeah, I honestly thought the glass had broken because it was so painful. I forgot how much they hurt when they sting. But, yeah, that's pretty much as exciting as it gets for me at the moment. Don't forget, there is a fundraiser to help fund the funeral of my soul sister's daughter, Bethany, age only 19 in April. Which, yeah, that's, if you could just go and give it a like, give it a share, anything like that. I know some of you have donated already, which is amazing. Thank you so, so much from the bottom of my heart. I really appreciate it. Anything like that. I know my algorithm is quite low at the minute, so anything that doesn't go on the Facebook group, which is all linked below, all the info is below, will be going on eBay, and then everything will be donated to the GoFundMe page. But any likes, shares, anything like that, I really appreciate it. I had hoped to get it shared on more Facebook groups, but unfortunately quite a few of them won't accept that sort of thing, and I only had one of the groups I tried to share it to who accepted it. So that didn't really go to plan, to get it seen. So if anyone can share it, that'd be amazing. So yeah, let's go on to the next mini. Now the next one I have is, I'm going to have to open it first to show you because my address is on the front. This is from Head Geek. I'm just going to show you how it's wrapped because it's quite big, so I'll just bring one thing over at a time. So I was speaking with them and explained about, you know, wanting to cover my baldness, and she recommended these. So, and I printed, well, I did, because I'm very indecisive. I am rubbish at making decisions. So I picked out a load of fabrics I liked and just said, just pick which ones you think, go for it. Any of the ones that I've picked that I like, I'll be happy with. And so it was a bit of a surprise. So I had this one first. I love this, and it's like a head handkerchief scarf thing to put over my head, and then you tie it around the back. So that's my first one. And she was really lovely to talk to, really easy to talk to. And then this was my second one, and she did it this type this time. So we've got this one which ties at the back, and this one which is like a, you know, pulley elastic bandy thing in peacock eyes, which I thought was cool. I haven't worn these either, I'm waiting to show you. Then I got a bucket hat which is reversible. I've seen these on there before. This was probably one of my favourite fabrics, lavender butterflies, you know the drill, I love them. And little glow bums. And then inside, love this one as well. We've got, you can reverse it, and we've got celestial. I thought that was cool. So those are my three buys from Head Geek. And all of the details will be below. Really professional, lovely lady to talk to. You know, chatty, easy to get along with. Really recommend them. Go give them a like. Go follow them. They also do quite a few of the markets, which is where I first saw her. Let's just move some of these along. And yeah, so go check them out. So there is my three items from Head Geek. I might move you down a bit so you can actually know. What I will do is I will pop these over here so you can see them. So yeah, really, really nice company, easy to deal with, loved it. Can you see them there? You can. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4 so far. Got a big one to show you now, and I need to say sorry to the vendor. Mind you, she wouldn't have known that I was doing this. None of these companies, well, Aura Blends will know because I've been on here before, but and so will Coven, but UK, but this company and this company won't know because I don't usually share the links until I've filmed and it's gone out, because I want it to be a genuine review. I don't want to be, you know, I don't want, I like to make sure that the items have been sent out and that it's a genuine review, so they didn't do anything special with how they wrap things because they knew it was going to be filmed, if that makes sense. So this is a genuine sort of review. Nobody knew, this company and this company wouldn't have known that I was going to do this. So there we go. So on to another company which they wouldn't have known that I was going to do this. Now, I did... Yeah, I did open this box because I completely forgot this order was coming. And I was like, oh, what's in that? But this was way back in maybe the end of March, beginning of April. That's how long ago it's been here. And other than looking, I haven't actually done anything with this order. And I just taped it back up. It's just a box. I just taped it back up, pulling the tape off now. And that was it, really. I haven't done anything else with it. How can I lose my scissors? I've only been sat here. Right, there they are. So, this is the last one we're going to do for today, I think. I didn't just destroy everything, I promise. I'm so clumsy. Right, okay. Okay. Okay, so this, while I'm struggling to get the last piece of tape off, this company is one I found, I'm sorry about all the noise, is one I found via the online markets. So this is from Head Geek. I'm just going to show you how it's wrapped because it's quite big, so I'll just bring one thing over at a time. So I was speaking with them and explained about, you know, wanting to cover my baldness, and she recommended these. So, and I printed, well, I did, because I'm very indecisive. I am rubbish at making decisions. So I picked out a load of fabrics I liked and just said, just pick which ones you think, go for it. Any of the ones that I've picked that I like, I'll be happy with. And so it was a bit of a surprise. So I had this one first. I love this, and it's like a head handkerchief scarf thing to put over my head, and then you tie it around the back. So that's my first one. And she was really lovely to talk to, really easy to talk to. And then this was my second one, and she did it this type this time. So we've got this one which ties at the back, and this one which is like a, you know, pulley elastic bandy thing in peacock eyes, which I thought was cool. I haven't worn these either, I've been waiting to show you. Then I got a bucket hat, which is reversible. I've seen these on there before. This was probably one of my favourite fabrics, lavender, butterflies. You know the drill, I love them. And little glow bums. And then inside, love this one as well. We've got, you can reverse it, and we've got celestial. I thought that was cool. So those are my three buys from Head Geek. And all of the details will be below. Really professional, lovely lady to talk to. You know, chatty, easy to get along with. Really recommend them. Go give them a like, go follow them. They also do quite a few of the markets, which is where I first saw her. Let's just move some of these along. And yeah, so go check them out. So there is my three items from Head Geek. I might move you down a bit so you can actually know. What I will do is I will pop these over here so you can see them. So yeah, really, really nice company, easy to deal with. Loved it. Can you see them there? You can. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4 so far. I've got a big one to show you now, and I need to say sorry to the vendor. Mind you, she wouldn't have known that I was doing this. None of these companies, well, Aura Blends will know because I've been on here before, but and so will Coven, but UK, but this company won't know because I don't usually share the links until I've filmed and it's gone out, because I want it to be a genuine review. I don't want to be, you know, I don't want, I like to make sure that the items have been sent out and that it's a genuine review, so they didn't do anything special with how they wrap things because they knew it was going to be filmed, if that makes sense. So this is a genuine sort of review. Nobody knew, this company wouldn't have known that I was going to do this. So there we go. So on to another company, which they wouldn't have known that I was going to do this. Now I I did open this box because I completely forgot this order was coming. And I was like, oh, what's in that? But this was way back in maybe the end of March, beginning of April. That's how long ago it's been here. And other than looking, I haven't actually done anything with this order. So this is a company, technically two companies, but we'll get to that. That I found on the online markets. She does a few of them. And she's not too far from me. When I say that, like, because I live in the middle of nowhere, everywhere's far from me. But this person, I actually, like, it would be in drivable distance, you know, within an hour of me, which I was quite shocked at. I was like, ooh, that was really exciting when I realised. And I've always loved her stuff and never got anything before. But I kind of fell in love with this, and I didn't realise that both these companies were her. So one item I had ordered through Etsy, and the other was from one of the online markets. I will find out which one it was and link it below. But it was one of the ones I always frequent. And yeah, two very different products, but bear with me. She runs both companies. So, first item I'm going to show you, it's the one on top, is this. This is a guinea pig cuddle cup, which I got from her Etsy store. And it's so well made. It's for our guinea pig, Hetty. Now, sadly, Hetty is still on her own, which is definitely not ideal. I did guinea pig rescue for 12 years. I know, well, not everything, but I know a lot about guinea pigs. And I would never, ever have a guinea pig on their own. But I've tried all my contacts, and just typically at the moment there are no older guinea pigs looking for homes, and we don't want to sort of have the thing where we end up with, you know, perpetually having them. I've had guinea pigs for nearly 30 years now, but we've decided that, you know, that these will be the last ones. Hetty is now 9, which is getting up there for a guinea pig. They usually typically live sort of, well, 7-8 years. She's 9, and we lost her friend who we thought we'd lose, you know, we thought we'd lose her first, and we lost a friend who was very elderly, older than her. And we always use cuddle cups because they make them feel safe. And Hetty's, well, we got some, but they're getting older, and I thought we could do with getting a new one for her. And I found the Blue Moth shop on Etsy. Now, I didn't realise it was run as the same person, by the same person who did the other thing for me. But yeah, really good quality, all handmade. It's about a 2-week turnaround because obviously she's making these things to hand. Love the Wednesday fabric, Adam's Family fabric. Thought it was really nice. So we got this as a new one for Hetty. And I will probably put some pictures up on Instagram of Hetty in it. So if you want to see those, go check out my Instagram, which is linked below. So that's the first item. Now the second item, very different, is... ta-da! These. Rock Your Soul, which is probably the one that everybody knows. I love these shoes. I love the fabric, first of all, that she used. And funnily enough, that's too near that candle. Funnily, fire safety people. Pink Poodle 2, who I'll link below. She sent me a picture of a blanket in this exactly the same fabric design that she had found. I think it was on Shein, whatever you want to call it. And I was like, that's really random, because like a week ago I'd ordered these shoes with exactly the same fabric design. It's like she knows me. So yeah, I was like, wow, that is like, yeah, she knows me. So she sent me a picture of a blanket with this design on, and I just ordered these shoes a week before. I mainly got them because there's a little catch there, but it's fine. Oh no, it's not, it's the hole. I mainly ordered it because, well, I love this design, it's very me, and just because I have lots of boots and lots of everything else, I thought these would be a bit more airy for the summer. And since then, handily, because I've got a, I've dented the bone in my foot, in my left foot, from my accident, so, and it's kind of like here, so this would be quite handy because normal shoes are not very comfy at the moment, so I'll probably start wearing these now. And they're a bit more girly for me. I don't usually do very girly. So yeah, that's cool. Love them. And I want to get some of their boots at some point. But these are the shoes. Love them. And yeah, really well made. It's about a 2-3 week turnaround, which I don't think was bad really, considering, you know, how big how much detail and how big a thing it is to do. And I expect with the markets as well, they get a lot of orders in. So yeah, really, really love them. And also, just notice at the bottom, there's a guinea pig sticker. Charlene's going to love that. We'll put that on Hetty's cage. So that's that, because she lives, now she's on her own. She comes indoors. Usually in the winter, the guinea pigs would be in our garage. You shouldn't really keep guinea pigs outside in the winter. But now, because she's on her own, she lives in Charlene's bedroom in the winter, and she'll be going back out in the summer. Well, summer now nearly, but yeah, we're just sorting that out over the bank holiday so she can go back out and enjoy the sunshine. So yeah, and that's my order from Rock Your Soul. All the details there, they'll also be below. And Blue Moth Shop. So two very different things from two different companies and one very talented lady. So I think that's it for Midweek Minis this week. We've got Blue Moth Shop, Rock Your Soul. We've got, move them over a bit, our replacement necklace and the cool few different things. Can you see them there? Just there. Hang on, let me move them over a bit more there. From Coven UK. So thank you very much, Coven UK, for sending not only the replacement necklace but also the extra freebies, which is really nice. We have the Marsar Gate Tower from the Crystal Sphere, and we have a wonderful wonderful order from Aura Blends, my usual favourite crystal shop, and we have an order from Head Geek. So that's Midweek Winnie number 4. I hope you enjoyed it. I would love to hear any recommendations for small shops you've used, small shops, small businesses, any cool things that they sell in their shop, not just necessarily mystery things, anything you've seen that's cool, I'd love to know. Do you like these companies? Have you used them before? What have you had from them? I'd love to know that. I hope you're all doing well. If you're in the UK, I hope you have an amazing bank holiday, or you've had an amazing bank holiday, because this will be up on Wednesday. And you're enjoying the sunshine. But until next time, guys, I'm sending you all my brightest blessings. Goodbye.